And just like that, it's time for our weekly roundup of all the things Lady just ain't gonna do this week. Number one, tornadoes, climate change, and capitalism's deadly mix. A devastating tornado touched down in Kentucky this week with incredible damage and destruction. 76 people dead. 12 were children. The ages of those who were killed spans from age 2 to age 98. More than 1,000 buildings and homes were destroyed. In one community, 75% of the housing was destroyed. Now, as of this recording, more than 3,000 people are still without power, and that's down from more than 22,000. This storm affected more than 224 miles, which makes it one of the largest, if not the largest, storm in history. To date, FEMA has distributed over $550 million in aid. These kinds of tornadoes in December in Kentucky are extremely rare. And this, dear listeners, is the impact in real time of climate change. Stronger and more dangerous storms. But as if this was not fucked up enough, there's more. An Amazon warehouse stayed open and forced workers to continue to work alongside this dangerous storm. And as a result, 6 workers died. The company failed to cease operations until it was too late. There is a price to getting your goods overnight or the same day or even within 2 days. These corporations place productivity and profit over human life, as we've talked about on this podcast before. And the results are deadly. Just think about all those families who will have an empty seat at the dinner table. We'll keep you updated, dear ones, as more details become available, but suffice it to say that capitalism drives the crisis of climate change. When you place profits over people, you get deadly storms and disposable workers. Don't believe me? Just ask Kentucky. Other things Lady just ain't gonna do this week is lose our griots. So Bell Hooks is dead at the age of 69. The notorious and illustrious feminist theorist who died after an illness, according to a press release distributed by her family. All of Lady's timelines have been awash with grief, disbelief, and beautiful tributes to the many ways in which Hooks has shaped our lives. No roundup could possibly capture the impact that Bell Hooks has had on my life. She gave me language to describe how it is that we learned to hate ourselves, how our lives have been shaped by systems determined to break our spirits, our connections, and our hearts. These last few years have been marked by so much loss, but for today, dear ones, while Lady don't like losing our griots, Lady does love everything Bell Hooks has given us that reminds us of the infinite possibilities for freedom. So thank you, dear one. Rest well, and thank you for being one of our greatest teachers. Other things Lady just ain't gonna do this week is having the clock tick on voting rights and infrastructure. Well, dear ones, we're still hurtling towards winter break for Congress, and we have no progress on infrastructure and no progress on voting rights. And despite the rhetoric coming from the White House about being hopeful that a deal can be reached before Congress goes on vacation, it's unclear how that happens with Manchin and Sinema at the table blocking progress. Meanwhile, students from the University of Arizona and Arizona State University, Arizona being Kristen Sinema's home state, they have waged a hunger strike and are on day 13 of said strike at the time of this recording to pressure their representative to pass the Freedom to Vote Act. The organization who has organized this hunger strike is called Unpack. So go to unpack.org right now and make a donation to these brave young people who are helping to save our democracy. And don't forget to make your calls to Congress. Nobody should go home for the holidays without voting rights and infrastructure. If you don't know who your senator is, or you don't know how to contact them, visit our Electoral Action Center at blackfutureslab.org. Now let's move on to the things that Lady loves this week. Number one, Sex in the City. Okay, so the verdict is in. I'm never going to stop calling it Sex in the City, but the show is called And Just Like That, and it's the reboot of my most favorite and the most garbage television show in my repertoire. And that is actually saying a lot because Lady loves her some trashy-ass TV. So last week, Lady was talking about this reboot and feeling nervous about it. And after taking an entire day on Saturday to lay horizontal and catch up on all my favorite shows, the verdict is indeed in. It's worth watching, but get ready to cry some thug tears in the very first episode. So it's true, the show is still trash, but it now has updated itself to our generation. There are now Black people in the show, still as side characters that haven't been developed, but you know, some things never change. There's a non-binary character played by the legendary Sara Ramirez, and I'm feeling their character, and I one day want more depth from that too, because they're giving us a lot of word soup with no character development or meaning making. Now, the pros, however, is that we are revisiting some of the classic storylines from the show. For example, this week's episode, we go back to Natasha, who was the model that Big married when he moved to Paris for work and left Carrie brokenhearted, only to return to the States and fall into an affair with Carrie because, duh, they loved each other. Why were they even fronting like they didn't love each other? But anyways, child. Miranda and Steve are on the rocks again, and it's looking like not only is Miranda a functional alcoholic, she might also be a lesbian? Woo! I did not fucking see that one coming. And Charlotte, I mean, it's looking like her kid is trans. Oh, and then of course there's the fashion. So, ladies' verdict? We'll allow it. Tune in on HBO Max and sound off. Is you in or is you out? Other things Lady just loves this week is holiday break. Y'all, it is a real thing. I can see the light at the end of the tunnel. And as of this recording, Lady is about to be on vacation, on holiday, for 3 glorious weeks. But don't you worry. You will still get your fresh episode of Lady Don't Take No every Friday. But every other day but Friday, Lady is going to be planning her cross-country move to Atlanta, but also more than likely laying horizontal on the couch watching reruns of Sex and the City. It's one of my favorite activities. Basically, I start the series from season 1, episode 1, and I take it all the way through season 6. And sometimes I even take on the 2 movies if I'm feeling extra nostalgic. So reading books, I'm going to be reading like the one my dear friend Sarah gifted me from Samantha Irby, who's also a writer on the reboot, called We Will Never Meet in Person. Now, y'all, where has Samantha Irby been all my life? I feel salty that none of y'all told me. I'll be purging the last room in my house that never really got its due after my split from my ex. I'll be cooking delicious meals and staring into space without opening a computer. Oh, and then there's my 41st birthday coming up, which we will just call 40 Wonderful. Holiday, take me away. Other things Lady loves this week is the new season of Claws. So it debuts this Sunday and Lady cannot wait. Join me and catch the first episode. Let's see where this final season takes us, shall we? I might just need to spend Saturday going back to the previous season. I mean, I need to get it straight with Roller and Uncle Daddy and all the drama, so I'll be fresh to death when the new season comes out. Other things Lady loves this week is Jennifer Esteen running for California State Assembly. Now, this week, Lady had the great fortune of hosting a fundraiser for Jennifer Esteen, mother, nurse, Black, queer, Jewish, and fierce organizer running for California State Assembly District 20, which is basically San Leandro, Castro Valley, Alameda, Fairview, Hayward, Dublin, Pleasanton, Union City, and San Lorenzo. Now, we had a lovely time, all masked up, and I'm proud to support someone with good politics and a plan to get things done. But don't take my word for it. Check out her yourself and visit jenniferesteen.com to learn more about this powerhouse of a human. And let's send a Black, queer, Jewish mama nurse with a proven track record of getting things done for us to the California State Legislature. So this week, y'all, we raised about $5,000 and we need to raise $10,000 by December 31. Can you help? They're already on the phones calling voters and they'll be moving soon to door knocking, which I can tell you, it's not cheap. So if and when you donate, please indicate that you heard about Jennifer on Lady Don't Take No. Y'all are the best, and Lady appreciates you.